Hello everyone! Join me as we travel around the world to find the meaning and origin of the names of all the countries of the world. If you missed the previous episodes, check out this playlist. Also, don't forget to subscribe as I only cover 7 countries per episode, so there's a lot more to come. Today we start off with the lovely Caribbean country of Barbados. This is easy enough to understand. It comes from Spanish or Portuguese and it means the bearded ones. As is the case with the island of Barbuda, Barbados got its name from the long hanging roots of the indigenous fig trees. Or it could be a reference to the native Carib's bearded appearance. The word itself is of Latin origin, barba meaning beard, which in turn comes from the Proto-Indo-European bardeh with the same meaning. Colloquially, Barbadians refer to their island as Bim, which is thought to have been taken from the African Igbo slaves brought here in the 18th century. Bim comes from the Igbo Bimo, meaning my home or my kindred. Now let's go to Eastern Europe and see what Belarus is all about. It's a truncated form of the term Belarus, meaning White Russia. There are several theories as to how this term came to be. The most popular one suggests that the name described the old Ruthenian lands within the Grand Duchy of Lithuania, where the local Slavs have been Christianized. This is in opposition to Black Ruthenia, which was predominantly a pagan land inhabited by Balts, although this term was only used in Western European sources. Others suggest that it refers to the lands not conquered by Tatar invaders. The term Russia here has a historic and cultural, but not a national sense. Thus, Belarus is sometimes translated as White Ruthenia to distinguish it from the ethnic sense. Ruthenia itself also comes from the same place, meaning Russia, as in the land of Rus, who were originally Swedish of the Viking kind, turned merchants who mixed with the local Slavs, contributing to the creation of Kievan Rus. Rus originally came from Old Norse and it means the men who row. The Biela part, or belly, bello, has the same origin as the Latin Alba, coming from Proto-Indo-European helbos, meaning white. Now let's turn our attention to Belgium. They chose their name after the 1830 revolution against the United Kingdom of the Netherlands that led to their independence. It was taken from the short-lived United Belgian States of 1790, which was again created after a revolution, this time against Austrian rule. They chose Belgium because this was the name of their lands in Roman times, the province of Gallia Belgica, or Belgian Gaul. Those lands were inhabited by a mix of Celtic and Germanic tribes who called themselves Belgae, transcribed as Belgae in Latin. That original name has its origins in the Proto-Celtic and Proto-Indo-European Belg, meaning to swell with anger, referring to battle fury. So Belgium means the land of people who swell with anger. Let's hop back to the Americas and stop right in the middle. The Central American country of Belize derives its name from one of its main rivers, transcribed into Spanish as Rio Balis. It is thought that Balis originates from the Mayan word Belix or Belize, meaning muddy watered, which kinda makes sense. It's also possible that this term originated from the Mayan Bel Itza, meaning the road to Itza. Which again makes sense as rivers were used for traveling and Itza is the name of the indigenous people who live in today's Guatemala, west of Belize. A common legend that admittedly sounds cooler but is wrong is that Belize comes from the Spanish pronunciation of the name of the Scottish buccaneer Peter Wallace. Supposedly, he established a settlement at the mouth of the river Belize in the 17th century. But unfortunately, there's absolutely no evidence that this is true. Next up, Benin. The country is known by this name since 1975, when officials renamed it after the Bay of Benin, next to which the country lies. Previously and in colonial times, it was known as Dahomey. The bay was named so by Europeans after the former Benin Empire, which lied not in this country, but in present-day Nigeria. Benin is the corrupted form of Ubinu, the former name of the city of Benin in Nigeria, which was colloquially called Bini, then transformed into Benim by the Portuguese. Ubinu itself comes from the Yoruba language term Ile Ibinu, meaning house of vexation or house of trouble. Officials chose to change the name from Dahomey because that name also had little to do with their country. Dahomey was a former kingdom, and only the southern third of the country used to belong to it. While the Benin Empire had even less to do with this country, ethnically and historically, these lands are more tied to it than to Dahomey. Hidden away between some mighty Asian countries lies the small and peaceful country of Bhutan. The precise origin of the name is not known, but most likely it derives from the Tibetan endonym or local name for Tibet, Bhot. Traditionally, it is viewed as the transcription of the Sanskrit Bhota Anta, meaning the end of Tibet. This makes sense since Bhutan lies at the southern extremity of the Tibetan plateau and culture. Locally though, the name of the country is in Bhutan, it's Drukyul. This means the country of the Drukpa lineage, or the land of the thunder dragon. The Drukpa is a branch of Tibetan Buddhism to which most Bhutanese adhere. And finally, let's talk about Bolivia. In short, Bolivia is named after Simón Bolívar, the liberator, a Venezuelan leader of the Spanish-American Wars of Independence. In 1825, Bolívar asked the leader of Venezuela, Antonio José de Sucre, to choose between the unification of Charcas, present Bolivia, with the newly formed Republic of Peru, united with the United Provinces of Rio de la Plata, or declare its independence from Spain as a wholly independent state. Sucre opted to create a brand new state and named it the Republic of Bolívar in honor of Simón. 2 months later, using the logic of Congressman Manuel Martín Cruz, the Republic was renamed Bolivia. The logic was simple. If from Romulus comes Rome, then from Bolívar comes Bolivia. Bolívar's own name comes from the village of Bolívar in Vizcaya, a Spanish province in Basque country. Thus Bolívar comes from the Basque term bolu, meaning windmill, and ibar, meaning valley. So you could say Bolivia means the country of the valley windmill, although that wouldn't exactly be correct. And we're done for today. For now at least. I hope you enjoyed this as much as I did. Tell me what you think about it downstairs, and do hit that subscribe button if you want to see more episodes. If you really enjoyed this, there's a Patreon page where you can support my work. I hope to see you next time. Bye.